Hello all, I'm very happy to meet you all through this channel Fly High, Read Sky. In this video, I'm going to narrate the short story The Pie and the Tot. The Pie and the Tot, this is the story of two hungry beggars. In the story, Jean and Pierre, they two are the main characters. And the sad thing here is, Jean and Pierre, they two are the homeless beggars who are roaming in the streets of France. Their condition is very pathetic since they are shivering of cold and is extremely hungry. The society is too unkind towards these two people, and this is also one reason they have started to steal food. This play tells how they have tricked the cake shop owners into giving them an eel pie and a cranberry tart. The next character we can see here is Gaultier. He's always feeling proud of himself and is short-tempered too. He is about 50 years old and lives with his wife Marianne. Coming to the story, when the beggars asked help from this couple, instead of helping these people, they shooed the beggars away without giving any food or money. So the beggars were keep on standing outside of the shop. But this was not noticed by the couple. While all this happened, the mayor of the town, he had invited Gaultier for lunch. Gaultier wanted to present a big eel pie which he had baked last Monday. But because of his prestigious problem, he didn't want to carry the food by himself through the streets. So he informed a plan to his wife. That plan is Gaultier would send a messenger to fetch a pie from her. But how Marianne has to identify is if the man asks her hand to kiss it. Followed by this plan, which was overheard by Jean, who was still outside the cake shop. Jean asked Pierre to act as the messenger and get the pie from Marianne. Since Pierre was starving, he decided to do as Jean instructed. Pierre knocked on the door of the cake shop, and when Marianne opened the door, he told her that he is the messenger sent by Gaultier. Pierre identified himself by asking for her hand to kiss it. Suddenly, Marianne snatched her hand away and went inside to fetch the eel pie. And also she gave it to him. Jean was very happy and enjoyed the eel pie with his friend. Unfortunately, Gaultier was not able to meet the mayor and he returned the home angrily. After that, Marianne told him that she had given the eel pie to the messenger he had sent. After listening to his wife, Gaultier understood that his wife was cheated by the trickers. And after that, he shouted at his wife for her lethargic. Then only Marianne understood as she had been cheated. So in the other side, Pierre informed about a cranberry tart which he had seen in the shelf of a cake shop. So he asked Jean to go this time. Jean was very confident and he knocked the door, which was answered by the women. Jean was telling a lie that her husband is asking for the cranberry tart. Marianne understood the trick and she pretended as she is going inside to get the cranberry tart. Meanwhile, she informed her husband, who ran out of the house angrily towards Jean. He hits the beggar who betrayed his friend. Jean promised to fetch the pie to the cake shop and ran away out of the shop. Jean told a lie to Pierre and sent him to Gaultier. Jean told Pierre that Marianne would give the tart to the same messenger who came for the eel pie. Pierre believed him and went to the shop, and there only he found an extreme angry Gaultier. The sharp-witted Pierre, he informed the baker that he had given the eel pie to the mayor and there that the mayor is expecting him for dinner. Gaultier believed what he said and forget all the anger and prepared to leave the home to meet the mayor. Pierre offered to help him carry the tart to the mayor. Once again, Gualtier and his wife, they were cheated by Jean. The baker gave him the tort and asked him to inform the mayor that he would meet him within 5 minutes. So the play has been ended with a delightful mode with Pierre offered the tort to Jean. Thank you.